All right. So I have been wanting to do a little review on this guy here for a very long time, but I haven't had my goggles working properly, so I wouldn't have been able to have DVR flight footage, which would have made this video really, really stupid and not worth it. So I can finally get one out to you guys. Arris was kind enough to send me a little micro drone. It's the Arris X80. This is the box it comes in. If I can do this one-handed. So this is what you get in the box. A couple of things that I've changed. Obviously, these are not the blades that come on the X80 from the factory. These are actually Dow Cyclone Q2035C, so they're a little bit better. I'm a huge Dow Cyclone fan, so as soon as I saw that these were out, I ran and grabbed a bunch of these, and I have not been happier because they do perform just as well as the larger 5-inch and I believe 6-inch props. Another thing I did change, well, added to really, is a bunch of hot glue around the camera, just because with some of these crashes, you will bend and break off this dipole antenna, which I did a couple times before deciding to just throw a crap load of hot glue on the top of it, and it has worked flawlessly ever since. No issues, so yeah. The camera itself is a VM275T. It's a 25 milliwatt VTX all-in-one camera. These are actually really popular. I've heard a lot about them. People tend to build tiny whoops using these things, so they did make a good choice by adding this to the X80. The motors, they don't really specify what they are. All they really say is it's an 1100 series motor. They advertise them at 16,000 KV, which they do provide plenty of punch for this 30 gram without the battery, tiny, tiny brushless drone. So they're super efficient. I love them. I haven't had any problems with any of them burning out so far. And they handle these Dow Cyclones perfectly fine too. So the fly color micro tower comes with the 4-amp 4-in-1 ESCs. They are BLHELI S compatible and they will support D-Shot. I believe I have D-Shot 300 on here. I don't think I've tested the 600. Odds are they won't support D-Shot 600, but they do support D-Shot 300, which is a much better protocol in my opinion. I use D-Shot on all my drones. So the flight time on this, they advertise 10 minutes, but you're not gonna get 10 minutes out of this thing. I think maybe a 10 minute hover you could reasonably get, but I'm looking more at 4 to 6 minutes of flight time, and that's if I'm flying conservatively, which I don't, so more like 3 minutes. And that's on a 550 mAh battery, which you do get one in the package. It's unbranded. It is a 550 mAh 1S LiPo. It does the job. They work great.
Picking up a bunch of these 450 mAh GMB Flight Power LiPos. They are ADC. They work phenomenally. They're relatively light. They're a little bit lighter than that. I get basically the same flight time, but it comes with a lot more punch. So if you do pick up some spares, which I know you will, because this thing is just too fun not to have multiple batteries to fly with. So if you do, I highly recommend picking up some of these guys right here. They do have the 2.0 connection, so you're gonna get a lot of power and a lot of fun out of these batteries specifically. So some of the other things that come in the box, you will get a charger, which I've kind of bent mine. I ended up getting one of these. It is an Aokada, or however you say that. It charges up to 6 1S LiPos. It has both connections, so you shouldn't really go wrong if you have some of the older style connections. This charger will work just fine. It charges 6 at a time. Like I said, you could use either a LiPo to charge it, or you can plug it into the wall USB and it charges all 6 at the same time. Once you plug them in, it'll actually read out what each battery
cell is holding. So if you're at like 3.7, it'll go 1 through 6 and show you exactly how much is in each battery, and it charges them all separately. So when one's done, the light will turn green and so on until they're all done. And it goes all the way up to 4.2, which is what you want to have these lipos at. So pick yourself up one of these. I may or may not put a link in the description for it. They're easy to find on Amazon and they work great for tiny whoops. So these are the props that do come on the drone. They came on mine at least. These are the Gymfam 2035s. They work great. I didn't replace them because they suck. I just like Cyclone better. They're just as durable. Hardly any prop wash or oscillation out of these. They bend right back if you break them. Like you can see, they'll bend like that, and then you can just bend it right back and go flying again. Like I said before, you can't crash these things hard enough really to snap off a blade. And if you do, I gotta see that on video because that's amazing. And they also come with these unbranded props. I believe these are probably just Arris's in general. They're bi-blades. They will be a little more efficient. You'll get a little bit longer flight times, but you will lose the snappy feel of having quad blades on there. So I didn't really use those. You can also get these little prop protectors. So if you're new in the hobby and this is your first drone, these things will be really handy, especially if you're flying into walls all the time. You'll be able to bounce right back and have no problem. I didn't use them because I've been doing this for a long time and I didn't really feel the need to have prop protectors on here. I'm kind of used to picking up the drone if I crash into something, and I try my damnedest not to crash anyway, so I didn't put those on. And these rubber bands here, they are just literally to strap the battery to the bottom of the drone. I put some Velcro on mine just so it sticks a little better, but they wrap around these little prongs here, so the battery holds up. I never have them fly off or anything like that. And hopefully I gave you enough information on the actual specs of the drone. It really is super, super fun to fly. I love it. If I was gonna go out and buy one, I would definitely pick up this one or something along this line, because there's just something about tiny brushless motors that are just so fun. And yeah, anyone that has a big drone would certainly appreciate the power these little things have, especially on 1S. You'll definitely be pleased if you get something like this. So yeah, let's go ahead and move on to the Betaflight portion of this. I'm not really gonna show you how to like set it up or anything because it should just be good out of the box. This was an FrSky version, so it bound right up to my radio, no problems. I'm using the Taranis QX7, and it bound up just fine without any issue. So you shouldn't have any issue. If you do, there's plenty of tutorials on how to bind things, and I'm pretty sure the manual tells you exactly how to bind this tiny little board here. So if you need to do that, go for it. Anyway, let's cut over to Betaflight. I'll show you the rates that I have on here. I did tweak them quite a bit to get it to fly the way I want it to. I've changed the PIDs and all that just to cut out some of the prop wash and put my rates on there. So I'll walk you through all the settings on there, and hopefully that'll help you in the future if you want to troubleshoot something or if you update the firmware and forget what the settings are. I know I did that when I first got this, so yeah, I'll have that in there and you'll be able to reference it. And then we will cut to some flight footage, which will be at the end of the video with a little bit of music in there in my backyard, so you'll get to see how this thing performs. Running Betaflight 3.2.4. It is Betaflight Tiny Fish. So make sure you select that when you go to update this board, or it will not flash it correctly. Like I said before, you do have to have the battery plugged in or it will not recognize it in Betaflight. So make sure you do that. And yeah, so here are the settings initially for configuration. Like I said, it does run D-Shot. I have it set to D-Shot 300 and I'm pretty sure it won't go any higher than that. I've got my motor idle set to 6 just because I like them to spin when it's sitting there. It is running 8K, 2K for the gyro PID loops. It does have telemetry and all that on there. I have the anti-gravity on and dynamic filter. I don't believe those are set automatically, so if you want that on, you need to just put it on there for yourself. That's all personal preference. Yaw degree, the board is tilted slightly, so it needs to be set at 45 degrees.
I ran into that when I updated and I forgot what that setting was. So my quad kind of like flipped out when I tried to take off. You know how it is. It is running S-Bus. Like I said, it comes with FrSky, so it should sync right up to it. I've got the roll and pitch for my P set to 100. The yaw is at 90. Integral is set from 72 from roll. Pitch is 72. Yaw is 45. The Ds, I have them jacked up to 67 and 67 just because this little thing can handle a lot higher D gain, and it helps to cut out the prop wash because it's so light. It gets caught up in its own prop wash really, really easily. So I have that jacked up to kind of compensate for that. My RC rate is basically the same as my 5-inch Chameleon. I have it set for 1.2 on both roll, pitch, and yaw. The Super 8 is at 0.83 for both roll and pitch, and my yaw is at 80. So that gives me 1,412 degrees for roll and pitch. I think it's pretty important that it snaps and flips quickly because 1S's are pretty underpowered, so it's important to have quick rolls so it can recover quickly enough and you don't lose too much altitude. So that's why I have mine set to that high of a number. It's not that high on my 5-inch, but for this one, it was pretty necessary to have that jacked up. But anyway, RC Expo is set to 0.27 for roll and pitch and 0.24 for yaw. That right there would be personal preference. It depends on how smoothly you want things to be. I don't really like mine to be too touchy and robotic, so I have it nice and smoothed out so that it handles the way I like it to handle. PID controller settings, I have it set to 0.57 and 0.54, and my ESCs are going off. That's what those tiny beeps are. 0.57, 0.54, which I don't really know. I can't really explain to you right now what these mean. There's plenty of videos that will. But this is all personal feel right here as well. So if you want to try out these settings, go for it. It might not necessarily work the same on yours, and you might not like my rates. But if you do pick one of these up, go ahead and try out my PIDs. Let me know what you think in the comments section. And if you need help with tweaking it, feel free to ask away, and I will be sure to answer that for you. So the anti-gravity is at 5. Again, this is all basically what I have on my larger drone, so it's what I'm used to, and it works well on this little tiny Whoop. Yeah, filter settings. I am running PT1, and I have gyro notch 1 and 2 disabled. So it does run that perfectly fine, in case you were wondering. If you mess something up and you need to reference, here you go. These are the exact two that you need to have checked. Onto the receiver. This one enabled. It is the Spectrum Gropner, because this is running with the QX7 FrSky. So you need to have the channel map set to this, just so you know. RSSI doesn't really matter because this thing does not come with OSD, so yeah, you won't have to worry about that. But that is pretty much it for the Betaflight portion. I'm not going to show you how to update the firmware or anything like that because it is all in the manual, and I don't really want to do that with this one right now. So if you do decide to update the firmware, make sure to reference this video for the Betaflight portion so you can see exactly what the settings are so that you can make sure this thing is up and running and flying properly once again. Because when I first did it, there were some settings I forgot, and I had to troubleshoot it over the internet to figure out what I was missing to get this thing flying again. So hopefully this will help you guys not have to worry about that. So without further ado, and since my ESCs are beeping once again, I'm going to go ahead and cut to some flight footage so you guys can see just how well this thing performs. So yeah, I'll throw some music on that. If you have any questions, make sure to ask them down in the comments section. Like and subscribe if you haven't already, and enjoy the flight. Moving like the speed of sound. We can keep on the ground. Can't stay in one place. Keep moving like a bullet train. Like a bullet train. Like a bullet train. Like a bullet train.
train. These tracks left behind. You can't stay.